If a star explodes in a distant galaxy and no one's around to hear it, does it make a sound? No, but it does generate a truckload of gravitational waves, we think. Hi, I'm Ian O'Neill, space producer for Discovery News, and I wanted to take you on a brief voyage into what links some of the craziest cosmic events we know about. I'm talking about supernovas, black hole mergers, neutron star collisions, orbiting white dwarfs, and even the biggest bang of them all, the Big Bang. So what exactly connects them all? That'd be gravitational waves, and if you've been paying attention these last few months, you'll know that these wiggles in space-time have been insanely hard to find. Astronomers using the BICEP 2 telescope, located in the South Pole, thought they'd identified primordial gravitational waves embedded in the cosmic microwave background radiation last year. Unfortunately, it seems those signals may have just been noise. But that doesn't mean it's curtains for the search for gravitational waves and gravitational wave detectors, not by a long shot. Rather than seeking out ancient gravitational waves created by the Big Bang, the Laser Interferometer Gravitational Wave Observatory, or LIGO, is actively searching for gravitational waves passing through the Earth right this second. These waves were predicted by Einstein, and in a nutshell, his equations predicted that should a massive object like a black hole or a neutron star suddenly accelerate, decelerate, or collide, energy would be lost. But in these cosmic scenarios, energy is lost through powerful ripples in space-time, much like the ripples that race across the surface of a pond after a pebble hits the water. Although there is strong indirect evidence of their existence, we have yet to spot them directly, and this is where LIGO comes in. LIGO consists of two stations on opposite sides of the United States. It uses a highly sensitive method called interferometry to detect the tiny effect a propagating gravitational wave will have on space-time. As gravitational waves wash through the Earth, yes, I said through as in through us, there's a tiniest of tiny shrinkage or expansion in local space-time. But for LIGO, which has recently undergone an upgrade, such a minuscule space-time warping should be detectable, and since 2002, the project has been on the lookout. This thing is so sensitive that it's probing distances on the smallest scales thought to exist in space-time. It should be able to detect a distance change of 10,000th the width of a proton. Although LIGO is yet to see a definitive signal, it's using a process of elimination, ruling out where the waves aren't, and physicists are confident that they are closing on the first detection in the coming years. By firing a split laser down LIGO's two perpendicular 4-kilometer-long tunnels and bouncing those beams back many times, the interferometer can compare the two beams and detect any slight shifts in frequency. This tiny shift could represent the passage of a gravitational wave. Should that wave be detected by both LIGO's stations, the source of the wave could be derived, and we could see the beginning of a new era of gravitational wave astronomy. It's really cool. Although the LIGO instrumentation uses a complex system of shock absorbers, magnetic fields, and sophisticated filters to drown out any outside interference, the detector is so sensitive that it can still pick up false signals from strong winds or by passing vehicles. This only makes this search for gravitational waves in the proverbial haystack of noise even harder. Fortunately, this epic quest on the frontier of scientific discovery isn't short of some great physics minds. So students from Caltech recently created a colorful visualization to connect known interference events with the corresponding signal detected by LIGO. This eliminates terrestrial noise from the continuing search for extraterrestrial sources of gravitational waves. But will this be enough to finally tease the tiny wobble out of the tangled, noisy mess of space-time? Let us know what you think in the comments below, and if you're interested in any other cosmic peculiarities, check out my video about the weird cold spot in the universe and what it might mean. This thing is huge, covering 10 degrees of the sky, and if it's real, it will be the biggest astronomical structure in the known universe. So what is it? In a nutshell, we have no idea, and this is why it's so awesome. Thanks for watching, and subscribe for more DNews every day of the week.